In this figure, we want to look at alveolar air composition and how it's generated from the air we breathe in, our inspired air, and how and why it's actually different from it. So if we look at our inhaled air over here on the right side, we can see that the total pressure is about 760 millimeters of mercury at sea level. Well, according to Dalton's law, the pressure of a gas mixture is equal to the partial pressures of the individual gases in that mixture. And in atmospheric air, that's largely oxygen and nitrogen. Oxygen makes up about 21% of the air we breathe in. And so if we multiply that 0.21 times our 760, we get about 160 millimeters of mercury worth of oxygen in atmospheric air. Now that's the air we're breathing into our lungs. Now you might say, well, okay, that's what we would see at the alveolus, right? Wrong. The reason for that is we are tidal breathers. We breathe air into a lung system which does not completely deflate with each exhalation. Therefore, we are mixing fully oxygenated atmospheric air with partially deoxygenated lung air or alveolar air. Now, that's going to reduce the partial pressure of oxygen in the alveolus by itself. However, in addition, atmospheric air has a relatively low humidification, right? And so we're going to actually humidify that air fairly dramatically. It's going to become completely saturated with water vapor as we breathe it along those wet respiratory passages. And so the partial pressure of water vapor actually rises from near zero to about 47 millimeters of mercury. Well, that's going to displace some of the gases, the oxygen and the nitrogen, further reducing the partial pressure to that alveolar number that we see here of about 105 millimeters of mercury. Okay, why do we care? Well, we care because diffusion is driven by a partial pressure difference between alveolar air and blood. For oxygen, we need a pressure gradient from the alveolus into the blood that's fairly significant. Or 105 in the alveolar air comes in contact with the blood PO2 of 20 to 40. 40 at rest and 20 maybe during exercise. That means we still have a significant gradient driving oxygen into the bloodstream. This is important because it takes time for this equilibration to occur as the blood passes across this alveolar surface. If the gradient were not large enough, we might not equilibrate and maximize our gas transport across this respiratory epithelium. Of course, for carbon dioxide, we need it to move in exactly the opposite direction. In this case, the blood PCO2 is about 45, right? It's picking up carbon dioxide at our tissues and returning it to the pulmonary system. And the alveolar air PCO2 is now about 40. Well, in atmospheric air, it's not even over here. It's near zero, right? But because we don't exhale completely with each breath, we still have about 40 millimeters of mercury PCO2 in our alveolar air. That's a very small difference. The good news is the solubility of CO2 is quite good, and so it moves readily into and out of solution, even with a relatively small gradient.